Or a little more than 10 seconds. Welcome back, punks. This is the Punkery Show. You didn't know it was going to be today, huh? The Punkery Show is here. We are live from CNR NG. I hear there's a lot of stuff been going on. Your hosts are, so I timed my password wrong, Rashawn and Hendrick. But Hendrick is not here because I gave him 12 hours notice that the show would be today, mainly because I'm not going to be here this time on Saturday, and Sunday is no longer a possible day the show's had some shit change, you know what I mean? So from now on, the alternate day to the show being on is going to be Friday. That's the alternate day, right? Because a lot of times we used to have this show on Saturday whenever Hendrick would... son of a bitch. Whenever Hendrick would be in the woods. I forgot to turn down the music. It's all right. Whenever Hendrick would be in the woods on Saturday, the alternate day for the show was on a Sunday. That's no longer going to be the case. The alternate day is now Friday. Now, next Saturday, I intend to be here. But, you know, shit happens, obviously. So that's really what it'd be. I gotta make sure that I can see the thread chat here. I don't know why I can't see it on Rashoff right here. Or does Rashoff not have permission to look at threads? Okay, here we go. Here we go. So yeah, Lucas said, why today I'm working? Same with Borrowed. Well, always working from home. But yeah, that's the reason why. Last week we were right here. I got sick from old man cough, I believe. Thursday night, or was it? No, it was Friday night. Friday night. I had a fever of 100.0. Felt like shit. So at that point, it was 9 o'clock, and I was like, you know what? Let me just go to bed. Colgate can be the co-host. Yes, he can. We've got no problem with that. Colgate wants the co-host, it'll be fine. But I went to bed for 11 hours, woke up. I was supposed to prep for the show Friday night. I did not. So Saturday, even though I still had a cough and all that, I chose not to do the show. JFCW posted a GIF of me semi faking my illness, which she's not wrong about that. It was semi fake. So, yeah. Decided not to have the show last week, so that's why we are here this week. Obviously, version 1.9.2 came out last week, and headlining that was the new HUD. The change of colors for warrants for level 9 and 10. The vehicle insurance thing was huge. And a few more things here, which I have to see the list off here. Improved HUD. Pretty interesting words for that one. All I can see is that if you're a fisher, you see the anchor next to your wanted level. If you're a gun runner, then you got bullets next to your wanted level. So it's coded by your skill. So improved HUD, that's a bit, you know, advertising, that's a bit too extravagant, but improved HUD. There's a new 24/7 playable bay, which I saw last night, but we really can't seem to enjoy that because I hear that there is somebody out here Adidasin. There's a dude or grill, you never know. It's 2022, right? There's a dude or a girl out here, DDoSing. I don't know who's DDoSing out here, and I know that people are trying to speculate to see who could be DDoSing NG. Oh, man. To be quite honest, I don't really think it matters. I know that it was sus for me to say that, because if I'm like, oh, who cares who's DDoSing? If you're Nikki Vasicki, you never know. You never know. You know, if I say, who cares who's doing it? Then maybe I'm the one DDoSing, but you know, I don't want to do that. Lucas said he knows he's doing it. P Pete Davidson is doing it, obviously, since he broke up or whatever the fuck with Kim Kardashian. And you know how the Kardashian curse is. Everybody who's ever gone with a Kardashian ends up fucking up. Nikki Vesicki is what Mr. Wick said. You never know. Nick Vesicki had a weird situation in Discord last week or the week before. I don't remember. But he's always been like that, so I don't think it's him. Ray 420 is what Preacher said. I mean, who knows? He's kind of a weird American from the state of New Jersey. Got that ass banned for talking crazy about Indians for no reason. I mean, you know, sometimes I wonder why people talk shit about a culture of which nobody plays that. Nobody's on the server with that culture, right? I mean, there are some Indians on the server, right? But there isn't a high contingency of them to start randomly talking shit about Indians on the server. Makes no damn sense. I mean, like back in Crazy Bob's, obviously, whenever you got into a problem with Albanians, people would talk shit about Albanians. But as far as I know, there isn't a high contingency of players from India, so Wild Ray 420 start talking shit about Indian. I don't know. I don't get it. Lucas also says, fat British man. I guess he's meaning Crazy Driver. There's going to be a Donkey of the Day again on Crazy Driver on Saturday night, because that's seemingly the only time I have to do this. Do it. He quits to avoid in front of seven people. It's in Crazy Bob, so stick around for that. Some saying it was Hollow quits, right? I mean, or the Sniper Gnag, obviously, as all the Crazy Bob's members seem not to realize. It's a 17, 18-year-old game. It is basically free now. I mean, who buys San Andreas in 2022? So it's basically a free game, and cheaters run rampant, and there's no defense for it. So what can you say about it? So, you know, and obviously, as Holquits and all those guys have to buy the game, and if they get banned once, they got to buy the game again. So who knows if they're not the ones doing the DDoSing, but I don't have any other ideas who is DDoS in the server. Could be somebody from the Sino server. Who knows? Same name, different kind of server, honestly. So who knows what that is? Usually people DDoS servers that are constantly popping, right? And this server only intermittently pops based on whether or not there's an event or an update. But it's been difficult to get a grasp on a consistent player base, which is why it makes you wonder why somebody would DDoS this server in the first place. But who knows? Maybe it's Corky. I mean, I don't know. You can list any name out there that you might. But, you know, these things usually pass anyway, probably after a few weeks. I don't know what it takes to DDoS. I don't know if it costs anything. Burger King. We'll get to that in a second. But yeah, this type of thing usually passes after a few weeks. So I'm sure that there'll be some dude that'll get bored of DDoS and they'll stop after a few weeks. People used to DDoS Crazy Bob's and cheat, and it would be a few week episode, and then it would end. I don't know. Again, how this works, if better DDoS protection is needed. See, it depends on how they acquired their botnets, whether or not they're paying. If they're paying, that's pathetic, quite. You know what I mean? Lucas knows, again, who's DDoSing. I want to see who the fuck this is. Who is DDoSing? It's Borald, huh? Pat Murek is the one DDoSing, huh? For voting time, obviously. We still have to have that Lucas versus Pat Murek political debate on this show, or whatever the fuck. It's the liberals. JFTW says she just ordered from Burger King. What did you order on Burger King? A chimkin sandwich? now that I think, is the guy's end key broken, bro? I don't understand this meme. Christ almighty. Double bacon cheeseburger. What are you, American? Hell, man, I haven't eaten at a fast food place in a long time, man. It's funny, because I went to the doctor yesterday. I last went to get a checkup 3 years ago. And I went to get a checkup today, because for the past few months, I've been eating... I've been doing the keto diet sheet, right? But I noticed when I stepped on the scale and all that, I grew 9/8 of an inch. So I basically grew an inch in my late 20s. So that's interesting. And I kind of noticed over the past couple of months that people that I've been around, when I look them face to face, I'm looking in a different direction. So I have grown an inch. GG. Burger King Talk has taken over the thread chat here. She want to be American so bad. Your ops want to be American deep down, bro. I'm telling you, especially when they talk about freedom of speech, which we'll get to in a little bit. To my Hardee's here, fries. My sister yesterday went to a place called, I think it was called Muya, or some shit. She got, many ounces of fries, and I was like, you know, these fries look good, but they're probably drenched in soybean oil. You know, I took three, I ate three, I didn't feel good about it, obviously. But yeah, when it comes to fast food, man, I haven't fucked with that in at least a couple of months. One more thing about the thread before I move on here. Banning you for sexism. What's going on here? Who's being sexist in chat? Oh, damn. The Killer Bird dropping a bombshell, huh? SMH, aren't you a woman? Can't cook for yourself? Space question mark. Damn. I'm telling you, man. I mean, I don't want to expand on that. I don't want to say that these days a woman can't cook or whatever the fuck it is. You know, when I was younger, I thought cooking was a difficult thing, but it really isn't. So... you know, these days, yeah, you gotta say it for me, man. So these days, you know, if somebody can't cook, you gotta look at them a bit sus, man. All you gotta do, right, is put the food on the stove, turn the heat on, and that's all you gotta do, right? Or I don't use the oven, but turn the oven on, that's all you gotta do. Or buy an air fryer, put that shit in. Set it to 375 for 20 minutes. Easy. Cooking ain't shit, bro. I'm telling you. Cooking ain't shit. Turkey healthier? Hell nah, bro. Listen. You know, there's a lot more nuance to that than that. You know, when it comes to pork and all that. I like pork. What are we talking about? What are we talking about? Anyway, yes. So, yeah. People are DDoSing and shit. Hopefully, they'll stop after a couple of weeks and stuff can get back to normal. But you gotta ride the wave. That's really what it'd be. You know, when people DDoS and shit, they try to get at your resilience. Be like, ah, shit, five players and shit, blah, blah. But after a few weeks, it'll pass. Hopefully the guy will get bored or run out of money or lose hosting or whatever the fuck it is. And it'll be back to regularly scheduled programming. What the hell is this? When the teacher calls you up in front of the class, when he was looking at the class, stop. Alright, well, I didn't know what this was when I looked at it the first time. No comments. Dusty Flop, I think, posted for me. That's what it'd be. My question is, guys, I don't know if Adev is listening, but since we have had the... bouts of DDoSing, is the Halloween event going to be extended? That's what we need. Is the Halloween event going to be extended? I hear that's going to end, fuck Halloween, well. I hear it's going to end sometime in a few days, but since all this has been going on, I'd say that we need an extension, right? Because I don't think enough zombies have been hit with pipe wrenches on the street. All right. Lucas says, the people in Berkeley are so confused. Anyway, when I saw that picture you posted, I was kind of confused too. Kanye West, Lucas. Yes, I have a segment on Kanye West coming up, actually. But, yeah, we need a Halloween extension. You know what I mean? That's what it'd be. Anyway, yeah, as Lucas posted in the chat there, what I was going to talk about last week a little bit, I was going to revisit the freedom of speech thing, obviously, as Lucas's favorite rapper got taken down. Many of his, sponsors have been compromised and all that. And I remember a few months ago, I had a very, very small conversation. It wasn't really a conversation, in the general off-topic section with Movie Maker about freedom of speech and how the quote-unquote old view that only has to do with government protecting your freedom of speech is obsolete, and that it should be universal and literal, right? So you can say whatever the fuck you want and have, well, I don't know if he said this, but no consequences. Well, look at Kanye West, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know if he's doing a big brain situation, but he is saying whatever the fuck he wants to say. And all of his sponsors, or a lot of his sponsors, have thrown themselves away from him. So, whenever a cocksucker talks about freedom of speech, well, look at Kanye West, he's got freedom of speech, right? Say whatever the fuck he wants. Talking about, what do you say about Jews, Lucas? Can you say it in chat, please? I'll repeat it on the show. What do you say about Jews? I know he knows this by heart. That's why I want him to say it or type it. He says something about Jews. So he said, I'm going to DEFCON 3 on Jewish people, right? You know, if people's idea of universal freedom of speech was a thing, well, I could say that. And then they couldn't do shit, even if they're paying me. I couldn't do shit, you know? Or rather, even if I'm paying them and they say something like that, oh, well, freedom of speech, I can't stop paying him, right? I can't criticize what he's saying because freedom of speech, right? I mean, in some way, it's kind of censorship to not react to something that someone says it's dumb. So it's kind of an oxymoron, to be quite honest with you. You know what I mean? So, whenever anybody talks about that, and whenever seen our players talk about freedom of speech as well, just my brain just kind of twitches a little bit. You know what I mean? So that's really what it'd be. I still gotta watch the Drink Champs episode. I haven't watched Drink Champs in a very long time, but I do like Nori and DJ EFM. But I gotta watch that. He apologized a lot. Nori did after the interview with Kanye West, which I don't understand why he's apologizing, because, you know, when you bring somebody on your show that is, for lack of a better word, radical, right? You know they're gonna say crazy shit. So why are you apologizing? But, you know, it's what it'd be. Yeah, I'm gonna watch it later today, or I'll listen to it when I go out today. But we'll then see about that. So freedom of speech, go fuck yourself. Before we finish, because this is gonna be a very quick show, ladies and gentlemen, all right? We might do agree or probably not, because Hendrick's not here and Lucas is at work. And I don't have any agree or re's, finish, yes. As I told you, very quick show, man. But I have been messing around, because I'm still trying to do the version 1.9.2 video here. I'll work on it later today. Maybe by Saturday night, I'll get that video out, I suppose. But for the past couple weeks, I've been messing around with render resolutions in GTA 5, 5M, right? And about a month ago, we had a very bad simulcast stream to show y'all how to get more FPS in the game. But I'm a guy that likes quality over performance, all right? So I've been messing around with increasing the render resolution of the game. But when you increase the render resolution, you lower FPS. Your FPS goes to shit. So I'm going to post 3 screenshots in the thread chat, ladies and gentlemen. All right. And I want you all to help me make this decision. Now, if you're on a phone, I guess it's going to be a bit difficult because you're on a smaller screen. But if you're on your PC, you can help me make this decision because I want to know through other people's eyes if increasing the render resolution, the quality increase that you get from that is worth the FPS loss. All right. So I'm going to post 3 screenshots in the chat. I'm going to post 3 screenshots in the chat. And I want y'all. Fuck. Okay. First of all, let me put the render resolutions in the chat. First of all. Fuck. Okay. Hold on. I want to make sure this is correct. All right. So I want to list out the render resolutions of the 3 screenshots I'm going to post in the chat. Fuck. Fuck. Where is it? Son of a bitch. Hold on. I have to go to full screen for this shit. And I want y'all to tell me which looks the best, which looks the worst, and which is in second place. Alright, so. Alright, here is screenshot number. Oh, son of a bitch. Here's screenshot number 1. There's number 1. Fucking up. So my Windows skills go down every time I do this show, man. I'm telling you. All right, screenshot number 1. This is screenshot number 2. And can I read the pixels? Count the pixels. And screenshot number 3 is coming up. So. I want y'all look at those 3 screenshots, all right? And rank them by quality, all right? So, let's say the first screenshot is the highest quality. You'd put 1. If the third screenshot is the second best quality, you put 3. And if the second screenshot, wait, hold on. Yeah, if the second screenshot is the worst quality, put 2. So, if you understand what I'm saying. GG, nice plate. Yes, V. That's going to be the license plate for the version 1.9.2 video. Now, I know this is a bad screenshot, I understand, because you've got the freeway just above, right? But, yeah, okay, so Lucas is posted, obviously. Anybody else, take a look at those 3 screenshots, rank them by highest to lowest quality. So again, if the first screenshot is the highest quality, and the third screenshot is the second highest quality, and the second screenshot is the third best quality, you would put 1, 3, 2. 1, 3, 2. All right, that is how it goes. If the last screenshot, the third screenshot is the best quality, the first screenshot second best, and the second one is the third best, you'd put 3, 1, 2. All right. Can't tell from phone. It helped. Alright, so Decoy put a check mark under Lucas's, so he thinks it's 1, 3, 2. Alright, hold on, let me. Son of a bitch, I closed one of the windows. Not even I know what it is. Your 34-inch curved monitor, huh? If only you were in front of it right now. Right, let me put photos back up here. Let me get the answer here. Okay. And I can only tell by the timestamp at the bottom here, the Monday 11:36. Okay, son of a bitch. Alright, so The screenshot with the highest quality is the one Monday 11/13. Who is that? Three. All right. The one with the second best is Monday 11/26. Where is that? Monday 11/26. That's one. Okay, so it's 3-1-2. 3-1-2. 3-1-2, ladies and gentlemen. 3-1-2. Well, first of all, I'll have to do this again next week because we didn't get enough data points. So far, the conclusion is increasing render resolution past a certain point doesn't really increase your visual quality to the point where it's worth losing the FPS. Because, last time I played, I put the render resolution to 4480 by 2520. Which I don't know what... Is that 5K? What is 5K? That's not yet 5K. It's not 5K yet. What is 6K? Okay. Alright, well... GTA 5 really has very weird render resolution settings, I guess. But, what is this, Lucas? Jesus Christ. Michael looks thin, at least. But, I'll do it again next week, because I really do want to know if increasing the render resolution is a waste of FPS. You know what I mean? Because when I've been recording with OBS, what it used to do was if you get to 100% GPU usage, the OBS would, like, stutter, right? But I noticed over the past couple of weeks it has not been doing that, so I've been using it as an excuse to crank up the quality settings. Because unlike Duryana, I am quality for performance. But this is a mess of a screenshot. 800 by 600. Trash. Alright. If you play the game like this in 2022, then you need some kind of income stream. Because, you know, this is a mess. 800 by 600 in 2022, bro. Listen. Put down the volume, if you're candy ass especially. Put the volume down. Get some income. Get a new graphics card. Stop being a cheap piece of shit. That's what it be. That's what it be. So, yeah, as if that would happen. Like, well, probably not. No, it won't. Well, in that case, maybe I'll bump the render resolution to like 4K or something. But, going past that, I guess, doesn't really make any sense. So, again, thank you for the test, obviously. I'll do it again next week, because I really want to know. But, yeah. I actually don't have something else right here. Agree or re only works with two people, so I'm not going to do it by myself. Plus, I don't have any agree or re's written down right here, so we're not going to do that. Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. I'll join. You're back at the shop for agree or red. Okay. We'll have to look at it like live to see, because I haven't looked at the suggestion area. So if Lucas wants to get on here for agree or re, we'll just bullshit three or four of these. I'll invite you from now while I take a look at the forearms. There's only a few here. Lucas here. You're on the phone right now. I've got to ask him if he has an iPhone or Android. That's what I need to ask him. Okay. I see a suggestion here by Luffy. It's called CNRNG Cinema. CNRNG should add a movie theater where players can watch YouTube videos at downtown Vinewood, Los Santos. It's like the theater... drive-in theater in Fort Carson back in San Andreas, but I would ask Lucas if you're re here, but doesn't seem like he is. Re agree some bitches. Any on slipstreaming feature added to the server. What is this? Is that what I'm talking about? Slipstreaming? Is that what that means? Oh, son of a bitch. No. Formula One. I don't know what the fuck this is, bro. What is this? Is it working? No, it's not. No, no. Look, this is not. You're gonna have to explain slipstreaming for me, honestly. Okay, let me read this. Okay. Slipstreaming is an aerodynamic technique commonly used in real-life Formula One. It occurs when an F1 car is lined behind another to gain extra speed. This is thanks to the F1 car in the front punching a hole in the air for the F1 car behind them, and thus reducing the air resistance applied to the F1 car behind. Due to that hole in the air, you indirectly lose downforce, and as a result, it becomes slightly harder to steer. So, does that mean, like, if you're tailgating someone, it is more difficult to maneuver? Is that what that means? You catch up... So your speed slightly increases, like if you're following the same path or directly following the same path of somebody in front of you. That's what I got out of that, huh? Okay. All right, well, you know, I've got bias against stuff that originates from Formula One, but this sounds interesting. So I guess I'll say good to that, huh? Yeah, Lucas's AirPods are not working. Damn, rip in peace. We're all defective today, huh? If Snoopak and the Ganag can put the physics in for slipstream, yeah, why not? Why not? It can add some interesting stuff. Interesting differences to chases, I suppose. You know what I mean? It's already in. What? Ah, okay. I didn't know that. I thought it was just an idea. Well, then, in that case, somebody else has to give ideas about that. Hopefully after the DDoSing end, maybe. Yeah, that sounds good. That's all I can say about that. About the cinema thing that Luffy put up here. My question is, can only one person watch YouTube videos in downtown Vinewood at a time? That's my question. And how would you input the video? And for example, what if somebody plays an age-restricted video, right? How would that be filtered out? That's my question, because I'm sure that there will be a couple of cheeky people that'll go to that area just to watch YouTube on phone. Just watch YouTube on phone. Why do you need a CNRNG cinema, you bitch? I don't know, man. To show your friends what type of shit you want to watch. I don't know. That's what it'd be. It's like how Discord implemented that YouTube party watch shit. Luffy did. He suggested that. Luffy. Right. Let's do one more here. We'll do more formal agree-arees of this next week when Hendrik gets back. You have some words? Well, you can't say them. Your AirPods aren't working, man. Or your phone's not working. So, what can we do about that? You have some texts. Okay. Put your texts down. I'll read them as we go to the next one. The last one. Jinasuke is the only other suggestion here that I see that is new. And he says... This is custom plates purchase / insurance. Hello! Latest update brought us car insurance. And I think it would be a nice addition for players to be able to purchase custom license plates for their cars at the insurance as well. When visiting the lots, have an additional option called purchase a custom plates. Prices. Three characters. Oh, an example. Three characters, for 200k. 4 to 5 characters, 150k. 5 characters, 100k. When in a car, you type slash plate, and the menu would open to apply one of the plates. Would open to apply one of the plates you own to a car you're currently in. yeah, Lucas. That, let's see. And Mad Kid said an option to sell place number players. Okay, well, I'm confused with this one, to be honest with you. Because, yes, as Lucas said, doesn't plate exist already? Or is that already... Is slash plate a donator thing? Yes or no, first of all. Because I don't know. I use slash plate, as you saw on the screenshots. Is slash plate a donator thing? Yeah? Okay. The other thing I'm confused about is that he... Even though he said it's an example... He put 5 plus characters to cost cheaper or less than 3 characters. I don't understand that. I don't know what he's talking about there. But I suppose this is aimed at non-donators. Because if you're a donator, why would you want to do this? That's my first thought. Sell them. Mad Kid, he said something about selling them. I don't think Jinsuke initially said anything about selling him. Lonnie said the second idea of trading place to any other or any other item would be an interesting thing. Yeah, I'm a bit confused about what I'm reading here, to be honest with you. I guess this is aimed at non-donators because, again, if you're a donator, then you can just change your plate for free. In which case, well, I mean, who? I mean, for a donor anyway. Dusty Flop says, replace Lucas with someone who has vocal cords. Well, listen, man, I'm telling you. Your ops don't have vocal cords, man. I mean, it's very rare to get a year out of here and shit. So you never know. But yeah, I have no idea what to say about Junior's suggestion because I don't understand it. You know, I don't understand what he's saying with it. So. I'll leave that till next week, obviously. So anyway, that was half-assed. We will do a better one next week if there are more suggestions on the forum, or we'll just do the same ones we did today in a better way. So for now, before Sam is finished, if any punk wants to come up here amidst the DDoS era on the server to have their 2 cents, they want to say fuck you to the guys who are DDoSing, whatever the fuck it is, whatever you want to do. Put your hand up if you want. If not, then well, dead is dead until next Saturday. I don't know why Dusty Flop always apologizes, man. Come on, man. No apology needed, cocksucker. That's what it'd be. Well, I don't see a cocksucker's hand up, so I guess Sam will be finished right here, as always. San Andreas Mafia is dead. B-Bird, shout out to that guy. Having very many issues these days. As everybody knows, hopefully he comes back mentally strong. Get the soy out of the diet, obviously. What is this? Candy Ass posted a video. You're doing it wrong. All right, so let's see what this abomination is here. Oh lord, I'm telling you. Yo, put the volume down, man. Jesus Christ, what is this? So, as far as I can see here, this is probably 640 by 360 with 50% render resolution, bro. The CPU is pegged at 100%. It is pegged. Teddy bears every time 20 FPS, and we have jagged edges everywhere. Even slash DL is blurry. I'm telling you, man, put the volume down, use that money, and do something else. Jesus Christ, man, I'm telling you. You know, I don't know what you did to manipulate this, because I know this is not your normal playing setting. I know this is not your normal playing setting, so I kind of want to know what you did to adulterate this. Because your CPU is terrible, but it's not this bad. So you did something with this. I don't know what you did, but, you know. Yeah. So, ladies and gentlemen, do not be candy ass. Don't do this, all right? Don't. The PC is so terrible that your CPU is pegged and you only get 20 FPS. Don't do that because you're doing something wrong. You know what I mean? You want to enjoy your playing experience, right? You go out, you work all week, you come back, you want to sit back and relax. You want to play your game and all that. This is not sitting back and relaxing, guys. 17 FPS is not sitting back and relaxing. You. That video is nightmare fuel. Wow, a lot of fuel got spilled in that one. Is Sniper Gnag an NG now? Yeah, as we were wondering before. Hollow quits in the Gnag, if it's true, right? They know they can't cheat on 5M, because if they do, then they have to, you know, buy the game again, so it'll be a waste of money, so they're gonna waste some other shit and DDoS or some shit, oh, who knows? Or Corky, yeah, we talked about that. Corky, yeah. See, that guy has mental issues, man, I'm telling you. Mental issues, see? I'm in a Discord, right? It's Lonnie's Discord. Right. And, you know, these days, as I'm a toxic individual, there are times where I like to troll a little bit, because this is the internet. And I like to do this because about a month ago, I said to somebody that ADHD is not real. And they got very mad. Well, they got sharply offended. They didn't get mad. They got sharply offended. I was kind of surprised by it, you know, honestly. So I said again that ADHD is not real. You know. Oh, what was the alley-oop on that, actually? You know, why did I bring that up? Yeah, why did I bring that up? ADHD is not real. No. I guess whoever is DDoSing the server has some severe ADHD or some shits. They ate too much sugar, too much soy, you know what I mean? And they, you know, got the DDoS shit out, and, you know, they're causing all the problems. I don't know the fuck I'm saying, guys. We're rambling here, obviously. All I know is ADHD is not real. So you can do something about it. Stop being helpless, bitch. Anyway, that's gonna do it for the Funkery Show. We'll be back, most likely, next Saturday. If not, then I'll say something in the Discord, wherever the fuck it is. And hopefully Hendrik will be back, obviously. He is working right now, very busy man, of course. So, we'll do that. So again, for everybody here, thank you for listening on a Friday afternoon. We will see you next Saturday, most likely, on the Punkery Show. And again, ADHD is not real.